greetings and welcome to you all. I warmly welcome Paul Jennings and his children over in Sherry, Lisa and Damon, Nathan and Anne, Ellen and Paul's grandchildren and great-grandchild, family and friends of Ellen and Paul. We come together this afternoon to celebrate his funeral service of thanksgiving to God for the life of Helen, whom God has called from this life to life everlasting. We pray so that our good Lord may welcome Helen into his everlasting kingdom. We pray also for Paul and his children, so that our loving God may comfort them at this time of their sorrow and sadness. Helen was a faithful servant of God. Jesus will say to Helen what he said to the thief who was crucified with him on his right side. Helen, I promise you, this day you shall be with me in paradise. I welcome also Helen's family and friends who are unable to be present here with us in this celebration of Helen's life, but are joining us via live stream. So we invite you please be seated for our scripture. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in glory, and all the angels with him, and he will sit on the throne of his glory, all the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand, and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothes. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you? And the king will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did it to me. The Gospel of the Lord. I would like to take this opportunity to express our heartfelt sympathy and offer our condolences and prayer and support to Paul, Helen's children, Owen and Sherry, Lisa and David, Nathan and Anna, grandchildren and the great-grandchild, at the table of your beloved mother and grandmother, Helen. God gives each of us many gifts during the course of life. But his greatest gifts to us are the people who are dear to us and good to us. In Helen, God gave us a great gift. Even though you are sad now that the gift has been withdrawn, you should be grateful for all God has given us through your mother and grandmother. Faithfulness is one of the greatest and most important things in life. It is as precious as a gem and almost as rare. To be human being is precisely to be faithful. Everybody has some responsibilities. In a very real sense, we are all responsible not only of ourselves, but for each other. While faithfulness is precious, it is also costly. It is not an easy road. It is a hard road. If one wishes to be faithful, one must be prepared to put oneself together with one's pleasure, comfort, and interest in second place. Faithfulness is the ability to stick with one's joys, the will to struggle for it, and to turn the inevitable obstacles and setbacks into positive elements of one's chosen path. It requires not so much physical strength as strength of character, of soul, and of spirit. Though it is costly, even here on earth, it brings great rewards in its way. It brings joy, peace, and growth. There can be no happiness, no growth, except in the fulfillment of one's obligations. A person's moral greatness consists in being faithful. This afternoon, we are celebrating the funeral service of one who could truly be called a good and faithful servant. Helen began her faith journey at her baptism, and now reached its call in the kingdom of heaven. Throughout her faith journey, Helen bears open witness to Christ through her life of prayer and service. Helen was a dedicated and devoted person. This was seen not only in her devotion to the Mass and other liturgies, but in the way she lived out the faith in her actions, both within the church, but also in the wider community. Helen was on the Our Lady of the Rosary School Committee, always involved in fundraising, class trips, and working peace at the school and parish. She also volunteered her time at the parish with typing and updating files. Helen especially enjoyed Christmas Mass with family. Throughout the years, Helen has found comfort in faith during challenging times and loss of loved ones. As a grandparent, Helen enjoyed concerts, grandparents' days, and other activities at St. Francis. She was also very involved with her grandson, Sam, when he attended St. Patrick's Silver Spring. She didn't make a big thing of these actions. Most of them were done quietly in her own humble home. One of the greatest treasures in life is to have a work into which we can put our hearts and soul. Such a work will make our life both happy and fruitful. Helen, your mother, a wife and grandmother, was blessed in this way. Helen was a woman of great faith. She has shown us what love is and how we can practice it in ordinary, everyday ways. The loss of someone we love, someone on whom we greatly depended, is a shattering experience. People who give their lives to labors of love go straight to one's heart. And I am quite sure that they go straight to the heart of God too. It is not so much death that frightens people as a life without meaning. If we are at our task, if we are faithful, then death, even sudden death, is not likely to hold any terrors for us. People who are caught up in an absorbing undertaking cease to be afraid, even when surrounded by danger. The person who is at their post, doing their task faithfully, needs not be afraid of the sudden arrival of the overseer. She will not even unduly bothered should the overseer arrive before the task is finished. She knows that the latter will understand that she did not have sufficient time. She knows that for the overseer, it is enough that he should find his servant at her job, like a reliable sentry at his post. Jesus is the one who was totally faithful. He was faithful to his Father, faithful to the task his Father gave him to do. The night before he died, he said, "Father, I have finished the work you gave me to do." But his fidelity cost him his life. St. Paul too was able to say that his work was done. He said, "I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race." It is a blessing for Helen your mum, your husband, your wife, and your grandmother, to be able to say that she had finished her life work, to be able to say with St. Paul, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. Such people like Helen do not so much die as wear out, but of what they have done and achieved, and nothing will be lost. Everything is stored away and we are called to make up that crown of righteousness Paul also talks about, a crown reserved for them by the Lord, the righteous judge of all. Your mom discovered that to be faithful is not easy. It demands a lot of sacrifice. And this is the pearl of great price, the kingdom of God, that Helen has discovered through her faith journey. It has been revealed to the simple people like her, to whom God gives the gift of wisdom. Everybody experiences a desire for the kingdom of God. And if we lose God, we lose all. If we find God, we find all. Helen now has finally reached the shore of eternity. Now that all her earthly tasks are completed, she will now enjoy rest from all her labors. May Helen rest in peace.
Hey, for those who may not know me, I'm Sam, one of Helen's grandchildren. My first fond memory of Nana was when I was 10, giving my parents trouble with my homework. Nana has always been known as a stricter grandparent out of the two, so Mum and Dad decided to send me Nana's YHs as they knew I would not go around, and boy, they were right. Despite this, Nana and I bonded well over this time when our weekly catch-ups together. Nana would sit and listen word for word, helping, encouraging, and investing her time into me. Nana has always been a very hands-on grandparent to all of us kids, with it being going to our sports, dancing, school pickups or drop-offs, high-five, wiggle concerts. She never failed to say a few days and support us. When I first moved to Australia for Dad's work, I was lucky enough to live between Nana and Granddad's boarding school. Nana loved the opportunity to force me to the laundry. My stack of clothes arriving in on a Friday night, the washing machine would be rearing to go. Yeah, it was a fun occasion at the start of a school term at boarding school, and Nana and Granddad helped me settle in. Nana went to the end of actually making my bed in front of three other boarders, which they thought was great. I later converted Nana into a Shortland Street band girl in no time, but was regularly bunkering down, keeping up to date on a nightly basis. Nana was thrilled finding out she'd be a great Nana. She was so proud of being with my daughter Poppy, and it's amazing I'm grateful she got to experience that. Over the last couple of years, we've had the pleasure to see your true self, Nana. You were great to be around, the life of the party, at Christmas lunches and family gatherings. We all thought you'd be with us for many more years to come. We will continue to make you proud, knowing you will always be here watching over us with a smile and watch your good friends. Nana, we all miss you so much already. You have been a massive role in our lives, your family's built. I promise we'll continue to look after Granddad for you. We love you always, Nana.
Thank you. and you, Dick, winning the heart of such a beautiful lady. And it says, we got to grow up with what I think is the best mum and spiritually love her. She's the best mum.
Truly are the Rest easy, Mum. Knowing Dad will be well looked after by us. I miss you so much, Mum. I know you miss us. We will look up to you and you will look over us. You will be forever known, mind, heart and soul. You are the best Mum I could ever ask for. I love you, Mum.
Jump on the internet and text as soon as we knew familiar acts were coming our way.
Thursday night, summer came around for dinner. They watched movies with us. Some would come for dinner at least once a week to watch movies and play cards. I loved it. I tell you myself, in the church before the members, and the life of my we made together. She was one of them. Thank you. God, our comforter, you are refuge and a strength for us, a helper close at hand in times of distress. Help us so to hear the words of our faith, that our fear is dispelled, our loneliness eased, and our hope reawakened. May your Holy Spirit lift us above our natural sorrow, to the peace and light of your constant love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest, grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister and mother, Helen, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with them on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Helen in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, tend towards us and listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to yourself and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ, and are with you and with our sister, forever and ever. Amen.
not have the final committee for any from the private himself. Service at the funeral home, so we're going to have a final farewell and final committee for her before the body will be taken. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promised resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister Helen may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Because God has chosen to call Helen from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise her body on the last day. And your response is, Lord, have mercy. For our sister Helen, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Lord, you console Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Helen, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You raised the dead to life, came to heaven eternal life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring heaven to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all saints. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of heaven. Let our faith be our consolation and the eternal life of our hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord. Let us pray. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Helen. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest, grant unto Helen, O Lord, and let the faithful light shine upon you. May she rest in peace. Amen. And may your soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. And may Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Oh, the baby. the chocolate pudding can't go first.
I think it'll be chocolate.
White out and then we'll reveal.
Together, so happy together.